So hello friends, welcome to my channel. I'm at coaching center. So today I'm going to explain your chartered accounts fourth chapter, accounting policies. So accounting policies, meaning accounting policies refer to the specific accounting principles and methods to for applying these principles that are adopted by the enterprises. These principles that are adopted by the enterprises in the preparation of their and preparation and presentation of their financial statement. For preparation and presentation of the financial statement, they use these accounting policies. Policies are based on various accounting concepts and principles and conventions that you have already learnt in your second chapter of your chartered accounts. There are no single list of accounting policies. There are no small list of accounting policies which are applicable to all enterprises in all circumstances. They are not applicable for all enterprises in all circumstances. But enterprises operate in diverse and complex environment situation, and so they have various policies also they have, and the choice of specific accounting policies is appropriate to the specific circumstances in which the enterprise is operating. On which enterprise is operating, the accounting policy depends on that. And calls of considerated judgment by management is also one of thing. ICA, Indian Chartered Account Institution, ICAI has been trying to reduce the number of accepted accounting policies through giving some guidance notes and accounting standards in its combined effort with the government and other regulatory agencies and progressive management. Also, it has already achieved some progress in this aspect. It has made some progress. The areas that different accounting policies are frequently encountered can be seen here. That is the method of depreciation, depletion, and amortization and valuation of inventories, valuation of investments. And this list should not be taken as exhaustive, but it is only illustrative. As the course will progress, student will be see the interactive of various accounting policies. Also, they will have interaction and they will learn. So suppose an enterprise holds some investment in the form of shares of the company. He has some investment as it is, he takes it as share of that company. At the end of the accounting period, he takes that money investment as share of the company. So for valuation of shares, the enterprise may adopt FIFO. For valuation of that share, the enterprise will take FIFO, average method. Many methods are there to value that share, how much they have given. Some method is FIFO and average method, and many other methods are there. The method selected by the enterprise for the valuation is called as the accounting policy. So the method that is selected by the enterprise for valuating that amount of money that he has got for in that accounting policy is called in the accounting the method he use for calculating that amount you have got for your as investment is called as accounting policy. And different enterprise may adopt different accounting policies they may take. Likewise, different methods of providing depreciation, fixed assets, straight line, written down, etc. are available to the business enterprises, which will lead to different depreciation amounts. They may have different amounts they may get bigger due to different accounting policies. Select of accounting policies. So choice of an accounting policy is an important policy decision. It is policy decision which may affect the performance measurement as well as the financial position of the business or the company. Selection of inappropriate accounting policy, it may lead for understatement or overstatement of performance, and financial position also may not get. So it is believed that no unified and exhaustive list of accounting policies can be suggested. Which has universal application. That has universal application, you cannot suggest that. The three major characteristics that should be considered for purpose of selection and application of accounting policies, they are the WIZ, prudence, substance over from, and materiality. All these three characteristics have already been you learnt in your chapter 2 and chapter 1 also. So the statement should be prepared on the basis of the accounting policies which exhibit Turkey's true and fair view of the state and balance sheet and state of affairs. I will know about the true and correct view of balance sheet and profit and loss. So the basis for selection of accounting policies can be shown in the following chart, like selection of accounting policies based on the prudence, the substance over from, and the materiality. On the materiality, you can base on these three things, you can select the accounting policies. Example, wherein selection from a set of accounting policies made can be given as following. So there are inventories are valued at the cost except for finished goods and by products they are taken. Finished goods are valued at lower of cost or market value, and by goods are valued at net releasable rate, where a little bit more rate. So investment are valued at their acquisition cost. Provision for permanent termination in value have been made wherever necessary. Change in accounting policies. So a change in accounting policy should be made in the following condition. So that is, it is required by some situated or for compliance with any accounting standard, and change would result in more appropriate presentation of financial statement also it may lead. So that's why taking correct accounting policy is most important. Next, change in accounting policy may have some material effect on the items of financial statement also. Like example, if depreciation method is changed from straight line method to write down values, to write down the value method, or if cost formula used for inventory valuation is changed from weighted average to FIFO, or if interest is capitalized, which was earlier not in practice. If interest was capitalized, that was not in practice earlier, or if proportionate amount of interest is changed to inventory, which was earlier not in practice, all this may increase or decrease the net profit. You may not know about the profit the company has got unless the effect of such a change in accounting policies is quantified, and the financial statement may not help the users of accounts to know about the position of the company. So therefore it is necessary to quantify the effect of change of final statement items like assets, liabilities, profits and losses, and these examples in the regard may be given in as follows. So Omega Enterprise, they revised its accounting policy relating to the valuation of inventories so that to include the application production overheads. And Upfly Enterprise changed the method of depreciation from straight line method to write down value method, which constitute change in accounting policy. That will do the changing accounting policy. So okay friends, this was your chapter accounting policies. So here you have some of the questions of accounting policies chapter. Here you can see. Here you can see, this one you can see. So accounting policies. So chapter 4 accounting policies. I think you understand this chapter. So okay friends. So if you like the video, please give me like and comment on my video. How you did you understand this chapter or not accounting policies? It is a late small chapter. It will give you a little bit information, and from the thing it will help you to use the things that you learned in chapter 1 and 2. So okay friends, I will see you in my next video explaining another chapter. Till then, take care, have a nice day. Bye my dear friends.